Hi guys. Hey Marquain. A bit more of an update on this Gazelle bike from 1931. Just looking here at the saddlebags. These are canvas. There's enough left to make a pattern if we get to that point. But they're pretty well worn and all these straps and the leather's gone, so I think we need to make another one. So I just thought you might like a look at them. That's probably what colour it was originally. Not quite as faded underneath. This is the coat guard on the chain. This is, it appears to be some sort of a canvas too. It's quite thick, but it's very, very brittle. It's had press studs to hold it all in place and little clips. So there's probably enough there to make a pattern too. But it's just a mess too. So that's another job. So that coat guard goes on this, which is cleaned up a fair bit. It's been in there. You might have a look at my other video on setting up a electrolysis tank for rust removal. I've had this in there for a couple of days and this is all cleaned up. There's not a lot of paint left on it. I don't think the electrolysis really lifted the paint. I haven't had it in there long enough. But all the paint's, all the rust's gone, and I think I'm just going to go ahead and completely repaint the bike because there's not much left. And there's not going to be a whole lot of the bike. It's probably going to be real original when I've done. New wheels and some saddle work and new brake parts. Really, I think I'm going to go ahead and put a coat of satin on it and some pinstriping. So that's the chain guard and how it's cleaned up. I'll put a link up for the other video so you can see what I've done. But that's nice and clean. This is the saddle. That's been in there too. This is spring loaded. I don't know who made it. It might be an original one. It's 84 years old. Anything's possible. The outer or the top for the saddle is a bit worn. This is horsehair. Goes on there. And the rest leather. So we're going to need some new leather at least, and probably some felt or horsehair or something to do that. That's another interesting challenge. This is the two main pedals, the cranks, and they've both got fairly considerable bends in them when you take them off. You set them so that they're nice and neat there. They point in different angles here in different directions, like they probably shouldn't. If you have a look at that, it makes the bike a bit difficult to ride, I think. So they're going to need straightening out. I've spent today making up a jig, and I'll make a special video about that later on. But we're going to have a go at straightening them. They're just forged steel, so they should straighten okay without too many side effects. And that's another project that needs to be done. So I've pulled the wheels apart. That's the other huge thing I've done this weekend. This is the front hub. There's no markings on it. It's just pressed in. It's not even close to the one that should be on it. This one is probably quite a bit later. It was in the old wheel. And it's only got 32 spokes as well, which is not right for a Gazelle. This one is German. This is the back hub, or the one that was on it. This is a Sachs torpedo. It's stamped DRP, or Deutsch Reich. And patent system. and it's stamped 1940, so sometime during the Second World War, this was made in Germany. It would have been originally painted black. I think it's a black one, rather than nickel-plated. And it's all operating, and it's in not bad condition. It's a coaster hub. But it's not the right one for this bike. The right one is a Sturmey Archer and a K-series, which is 1925-1930 made. And that's a little bit elusive because most English hubs have got 40 spokes and the Dutch one's got 36. So at some point we've got to find one with 36 holes around here. Or a Gazelle back hub. So they're the options. I don't know which one's going to be easier, but that's what we're looking for at the moment. It needs to have 36 holes, and it needs to be genuine, or a little bit genuine to the bike, the Dutch 1931 cycle. So that's the back hubs. The last thing I've been looking at is this crank set, is the bottom bracket set, which is a bit rough. I haven't cleaned it up a whole lot, but these ball races here seem to be sort of fair to middling. I think they'll clean up okay. It might need a bit of a polish. And there's the sprocket with the four gazelles in it. There, and there. So that's the right sprocket for the bike. It's going to need a bit of a clean up. And it's a nickel plate, but I think we can pretty much resurrect that, so I'm pleased about that. So that's about it for this video. It's just a bit of a look at this old bike and what's happening with it, and all the bits I've got and what needs to be done. There's lots of repairs that need to be made, and new bits need to be put together, and we're still looking for bits all over the world, so hopefully some of them will turn up. The internet's a wonderful thing. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and like this video and leave a comment if you'd like to know something more, or if you think it's a bit long-winded. So thanks guys, and some more soon.